Namaskar. Today I will talk about Brahmacharya. It is the fourth principle of Jhama Sadhana, and it is about seeing the divine in everything. To see the divine, to feel the divine within your existence. When you are meditating, your mind becomes subtle. You become holy. The feelings of your mind, the instincts of your mind become divine. You only want to grow, you want to love, you want to serve. But when you open your eyes, the moment you open your eyes, the environment starts to affect you. And the mind starts to descend. And then you are descending, you go for your job, you do your mundane tasks, you deal with many limited objects, and you are descending and descending and descending until the moment you are feeling that you are not a spiritual person anymore. What does it mean? That the life has become just an empty struggle. It is not the flow of joy anymore. So how to be spiritual? How to always remain spiritual? This is practice of Brahmacharya. Brahma means consciousness, supreme consciousness, the absolute. Or you can say God. And charya, it is to move while eating. In Sanskrit there are few words describing movement. Chalati, vrajati, charati. Chalati means to move. And vrajati means to, you're enjoying, you're feeling joy, and at the same time you're moving. And charati means you're moving and at the same time you're eating something. Like you're eating and you're moving. The cow is grazing and moving at the same time. So that is charati. So brahmacharya means to move and eat supreme entity. We are what we eat, and we eat all the time. When we eat physical food, that food and water becomes, they constitute our cells. So our physical body is what we eat. And our mental body, our psyche, is made from what we have eaten in the psychic sphere. You have read books, you have watched movies. Those very books, those very movies, they have become you. Your character, your nature has been composed out of those materials you've taken from the external world. Plus something from your past. So we are what we eat. And sometimes our environments are very uplifting and elevating. When you are in the company of the spiritual people, just by looking at them, you become uplifted. Sometimes, few times a year, I come to such company of extremely spiritual people. And in that company, I don't even want to meditate, because just by looking at those people, watching them, moving, sparkling with their beautiful faces, with their beautiful energies, I get so much charged. But unfortunately, such environments, they're not always there. Very often, the environment is of degenerating nature. So we have to learn the way how to always remain in that subtle state of spiritual ideation. So brahmacharya means to eat the divine consciousness. If you are eating divine consciousness, what do you become? You become divine consciousness. If you are eating spiritual things, you become a spiritual person. And that is very necessary. Sometimes even we do very good constructive work, but as we are dealing with the physical realities, and the physical reality is crude, our mind does become crude. As you think, so you become. Last year we had to construct a sauna. Our old sauna was burnt by accident. And the large program was coming. And we had to have sauna because so many people would, 150 people would come. So in the Siberian winter, in the cold, we had to struggle and construct a new sauna. And we were very engaged, we were very intent to accomplish our work in time. One day I came home, I sat for meditation, and I found that I am not able to concentrate. Images of the sauna. I am cutting the wood, I am screwing the screws, I am planning the roof, installing the pipe. But I am not able to meditate. Because as you think, so you become. Your mind becomes crudified. It likes to think about the crude things. And is unable to catch that subtle flow of consciousness. So I struggled. And this, it occurred to me that, yes, actually, I am not doing my practice properly. I am not following the principle of brahmacharya. Okay, tomorrow I should try a little more. And next day I really did try. And it was much better when I meditated. How to do that? Brahmacharya, when you practice, in the midst of your activity, you stop for a while, you close your eyes, and you try to feel that flow of joy and inspiration and subtlety. Feel that all around is consciousness. And then again, move ahead with what you are doing. To practice brahmacharya, there are three things. If you follow this, wow, you will enjoy. Those three things really helped me to restore, to create proper ideation. One needs to renounce the desire for the result of action. When you desire a certain result, you are not able to feel the harmony with the Supreme, because maybe Supreme desires something else. So if you want to be in harmony with the Supreme, you need to let go. You need to make your best effort, and at the same time you should be emotionally detached from the result. So how to do that? It is very unnatural for us. We do something because we want something, isn't it? It is, like that. So it would be very unnatural to renounce the result. But through love, it is very natural. When you imagine, when you think, I'm going to do something, and this, whatever result will come out of what I'm doing, I am offering as a gift to the Supreme Consciousness. The moment you think like that, you will feel sweet flow within your heart. You will feel bliss and love. And that itself is very satisfying. You don't need anything else after that. One friend of mine, he was an alcoholic, and he could not overcome this problem. And his mother, she came to me and she said, Dada, please do something. He is a young person, but he's ruining his life. And I say, what can I do? What can I do? And then she said, please, you try. Then, okay, he came for our retreat. And even in our spiritual program, he was managing somehow to get. Anyway, I tried. And somehow, in the last days, he felt something. Something that has changed his mind, attitude, everything. Ever since he didn't drink alcohol. And he realized that some miracle has happened. He realized that it was a grace of God. So he was going to do some work, and he was passing through some field, and he saw flowers. He said, this thought occurred in my mind. I would like to offer those flowers to God. And he said, the moment I thought this, I felt as if a shower of bliss flown through me. What was that? I said, this is called devotion. This is called divine love. He said, yes. That is a thing worth living for. I say, yes, I think so. So this is the first part of Brahmacharya practice. Whatever you do, you offer that to the Supreme as a gift of love. I love you. I do it for you. Another thing, need to renounce the pride of doership. You are doing, you are so proud of you doing things. And that itself is a very crudifying idea, because you are identifying yourself with the cruder parts, with the cruder parts of your mind. You are not seeing that one indivisible entity expressing itself through you. So to feel, to see that, you need to renounce the cruder parts of your mind. Think that it was not you doing, but the Supreme Consciousness is doing through you. I am very particular about my food. So it's quite difficult to please me. I want the food to be cooked in a certain way. Whenever spiritual people cook, I really enjoy. And I try to teach also people. And they sometimes ask me, okay, Dada, now you cook. You show how it should be. So imagine my difficulty. Now I have to really cook, because all those talks that I am talking, I have to perform. But I feel some part of some fear, some inconfidence. I may fail. Then I have no resort. I stand up in my kitchen and I'm thinking, okay, now I am offering myself to you. You work through me. You cook through me. And I'm doing this for you also. And then the food comes nicely. And if not, it doesn't come. You lean upon the Supreme Consciousness. You saturate yourself with inspiration of consciousness. You saturate yourself with the sweetness of love. And then your own mind, your own logic will guide you on the proper path. But that mind will be charged and surcharged and guided by love. So that is very important. And then the last one, you need to perceive and see that everything around you is also consciousness. Otherwise, you are in the mountains, you feel like this. You are at the bank of the sea, you feel like this. You are in the city, you feel differently. Everything affects you. You talk to a scientist, you feel like this way. You talk to an alcoholic, you feel that way. They affect us. But if you are talking to Supreme Consciousness everywhere, you are the same. So that principle is there for the joy, for the bliss of existence. I have experienced it myself. I am trying to live this way, though it is quite difficult to do, because the mind is assailed by so many material forces. But I'm sharing this with you, and I hope a few times a day you will just stop yourself. You will close your eyes and try to feel that flow of sweetness within and within of you, outside you. That will be Brahmacharya. In our practice, we have something which is called second lesson of individual meditation or Guru Mantra. You can learn it in course of time in the process of personal instruction from a teacher. I cannot teach over this technical means. So, but it can be taught later on. But the principle you know already how to do. And you can do it even with universal mantra or even without mantra, just to feel the divine. This life is there. Why we feel attraction to this life? Why do we want to live? Because of happiness. This universe is the flow of joy. That joy is hidden. It is hidden deeply within the heart of each one of us. The trick is only to uncover it, discover it. So you know all those three principles. First, renounce the results of your action. Emotionally detach yourself from the action by offering that, the fruit of that action to the Supreme. Think, I am giving a precious gift to the Divine. If you love someone, you are giving. You don't want to get that back. Even the person will say, oh no, it is too expensive, please. No, you will be hurt. You want to give away. You don't want to expect anything. Not even thank you. You want to give. You are enjoying that giving. Then it is not me who is doing. He is within me. That invincible force. Almighty. All-knowing. I can do anything. And then finally, He is all around me. Remember those three parts, and your life will always be spiritual and divine. Thank you very much for watching this inspiration. Subscribe to this channel. Let us stay in touch. Everyone needs a drop of inspiration just in time. And meditation steps is just for that. Namaskar.